hemiacetal structure?
So isn't it ether with hydroxy?
Carbon with ether and hydroxy, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next, write down hemiacetal structure of glucose. Hemiacetal structure of glucose. Just a second. Yeah. So cyclic hemiacetal structure. Oh, better we write here cyclic hemiacetal. Cyclic hemiacetal structure. So hemiacetal structure is the structure in which the carbon contains OH and OR group. If I give you a quick recap here that we did, the reaction of aldehyde RC double bond OH, because glucose contains aldehyde functional group. So that's why it's very similar reaction we have here. And when this is allowed to react with an alcohol, which is R1OH, the product here we get is RCOH, OR1, and H, if you remember this. We get this structure, okay? In acidic medium, obviously, H+. So this we call it as hemiacetal structure, where the carbon contains both OR ethereal bond and alcoholic bond, okay? How do we get hemiacetal structure in glucose? That is the question. Correct. So now you look at this reaction, first of all, because glucose contains hydroxy group also, because you see glucose has this also and glucose has this OH and C double bond O both present. That's why this kind of a structure is possible. You see, if I draw the structure of glucose here, here we have C double bond O, H, and OH, H, OH, H, OH, OH, H, CH2OH. Okay. This structure, it is D or L glucose? First of all, tell me that.
D.
It's D, right? Yeah. So this is D plus glucose. And this information I am giving you. How do we know plus or minus?
Sir, isn't plus it or experimental? Minus
is the information we get from polarimeter. Right. So this is factual actually. For this, it is plus or minus. You have to do that experiment. Rotation of plane polarized, right, clockwise or anticlockwise. That we only get from polarimeter. So this is the information I am giving you. I am telling you that this is a plus glucose. Fine. Okay. So if you want, you can write down here this information, whether it is plus or minus info through polarimeter. You don't have to put brain over here. You cannot do into anything into this. Okay. Now what happens here, you see, like I said, that aldehyde and alcohol reacts forms hemiacetal. Why it is D? Because this OH on the right hand side. That is one thing. That's why it is D. Now in the next thing, what happens here is this lone pair, oxygen wala lone pair, yahan pe, this lone pair. This has the tendency to attack onto this carbonyl carbon. Okay. Now when it attacks, this pi electron shift onto this oxygen. What is the hybridization of this carbon? sp2 and when this attack takes place, what happens then? We'll get the structure like this. Okay, so this is here we get carbon. With one side we have OH, and this is H. This is oxygen, and this is same. OH, H, OH, H, OH, H here, and here we get CH2, OH, and here we have H. Okay. So basically this hydrogen rearrange itself onto this oxygen, we get this. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. This carbon becomes sp3. Okay. Now point is what? This oxygen can be this side also, means the attack takes place from this side or from opposite side also. Why? Because the carbon is sp2 hybridized. So this attack may be from the top or from the bottom, both side is possible. The probability is equal for that. Okay, so we can also draw one more structure here, which is this. Carbon, H, OH on the opposite side, and here we have OH on the right, H on the left, OH on the left, H on the right, OH on the right, H on the left, H on the left, and CH2 OH. So can you tell me the configuration of this carbon and this carbon is opposite? If it is R, this one is S. Fine. Okay. So when these two structures are diastereomers of each other, first of all, and why it is hemiacetal structure? Because the carbon contains OH and OR group, ether group. That's why this is the hemiacetal structure of glucose. Cyclic structure we have, so it is cyclic hemiacetal. Is it clear?
So why does any other of the OH not take part in this reaction?
Your voice is not clear.
So he asked, yes. Why doesn't the OH take part in the reaction?
Ashutosh.
Aryaman asked, sir.
I am not getting you.
So he asked, why only that OH, why not the other OH?
It's almost six member.
Why this? I'm coming to that. Wait. See, advantage of this oxygen is what? Because you'll get a cyclic compound. Bharat, can you answer this?
It takes it from carbon number 5 because you get a six member ring. A six member ring is particularly stable.
You'll get a six member ring here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six membered ring, including the oxygen in the ring. That's why it is.
Sir, under what condition does this transformation take place, or is it spontaneous?
This is actually a condition is acidic medium we take generally. Okay. But this kind of reaction is possible.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Now, the thing is, this structure, we call it a cyclic hemiacetal structure. The carbon here is sp3 hybridized. This carbon is sp3 hybridized. Both of these structures are called diastereomers. Right? And this hemiacetal structure forms when hydroxy group attacks onto the carbonyl carbon. Second point is this. Now, this molecule, where OH on the right side of this carbon, we call it as alpha D-glucose. So it is D plus glucose. This form is alpha when OH on the right. So we call it as alpha D plus glucose when OH on the right. If OH on the left, it is beta D plus glucose. Okay, alpha, why? Because hydroxy group OH on the right. Because hydroxy group OH on the left.
So is this only for D plus glucose or even minus sugar?
See, alpha and beta is only for, this is again, why do we other one participant? Okay, Aleman, we understood, right? Okay. Huh, what did you say? Beta, for beta also it's fine. For, you know, for minus also it's fine. Alpha has nothing to do with D plus or minus. It is only concerned with, alpha is only related with hydroxy group, whether it is present on the right or on the left.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that is possible with D minus even also. And why do we get these two structure? You understood this? Because this carbon is what? This carbon is planar. It is sp2 hybridized. So attack of this lone pair can be from the top and from the bottom also. Both side attack is possible. So if it attacks from the bottom, OH group will be this side. And it attacks from the top, OH group the opposite side. So both structure is possible. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Write down one note here, all of you. In solid state, glucose found in these cyclic hemiacetal structure. In solid state.
Sir, if it is on the left hand side, so if it's L plus glucose, then shouldn't the first carbon be opposite in nature? So shouldn't it be an anomer? Either rotation should happen for the OH, or it should be anomer, right?
What is anomer? What is anomeric carbon?
Sir, anomeric carbon is a configuration in with which it differs in the alpha carbon.
No. Anomeric carbon is that carbon which contains OH group and ether linkage. Like this carbon is anomeric carbon.
Yeah, but it should differ.
Yeah, I think you are trying to say something else. I'm coming to that point. Can you give me 2-3 more minutes?
Okay.
So first of all, what I said, this is very important. In solid state, glucose found in these cyclic hemiacetal structure and this beta form is more stable. You write down this. Means this glucose exists in this form. Beta form is more stable. You'll ask me why. Yes?
Yes, so why?
We'll discuss that later. Reason I'll tell you, but uske liye you need to understand a few things. So we'll come to that. Okay, so horse preparation we'll discuss. There we'll see.
Is it then because OH should be on same side?
I'll tell you the reason over there. Okay. So here only you write down beta form is more stable. Reason I'll tell you in some time. Just wait for some time. Okay. You see, alpha and beta form are diastereomers of each other, and they also known as anomers of each other. You'll ask me what is anomer. So that I'll explain here. Write down. Alpha and beta forms are diastereomers of each other, and They are also known as anomers. A-N-O-M-E-R-S. To understand why they are anomers, first of all, you write down the definition of anomers. Definition of anomer, you write down. Write down, these are the carbohydrates. These are the carbohydrates which differs in configuration, which differs in configuration only at anomeric carbon, which differs in configuration only at anomeric carbon. Next line, the carbon which contains both hydroxy group, OH group, the carbon which contains both hydroxy group and ether linkage are called anomeric carbon. Understood? So in this structure, the previous structure, which one is anomeric carbon? C1, right? First carbon. This is the anomeric carbon, correct? Now the configuration of anomeric carbon is different. In one of the molecule, OH is on the right, and in the other one, OH is on the left. That's why the configuration of this carbon is different in these two compounds, and hence these are anomers of each other. Okay? So this question also they ask that in glucose or alpha D glucose, which one is anomeric carbon? They'll give you the option C1, C2, C3, C4. Answer will be what? C1. So in glucose, alpha D glucose, C1 is the anomeric carbon. And when the configuration differs at anomeric carbon, the compounds are said to be anomers of each other. Am I clear? Okay.
So that's what my doubt was.
Tell me.
So here the OH on the opposite side can't take place, right? It can't form hemiacetal.
Why? It can form.
How?
Your doubt is what? If OH on this side, that's what you're saying.
Right.
OH on this side. That will also form, so you'll get this first. Means if top side attack, suppose OH is on the left. Top side attack.
But here, it won't be glucose anymore, right?
Sorry?
It won't be glucose anymore. It will be
L form of glucose. That will be L form. That is glucose only, but it is the L form of glucose.
L form. Okay, understood.
So yeah. You will get this structure, but the point is here the top side attack, if it gives alpha, there the top side attack gives you beta. That's the only difference you get.
Yeah, okay, got it.
Okay. Now, see, one more thing. This anomer things is defined only in cyclic structure. You must keep in mind. This is a cyclic structure, guys. Don't, keep this in mind. It is a cyclic structure, 6-membered ring. So anomeric thing or anomers are defined only for cyclic compound.